Welcome to this Shaper 3D tutorial on the iPad for industrial design. Today, we are going to take a look into variations and we'll see how we'll use one model in order to create three different versions of a similar design or a series of designs. We're going to learn a little bit about import-exporting functionality and making good use of the rectangle selection tool, and we'll find a neat trick in order to find a contour of a rounded surface. So if that sounds exciting, let's go ahead and jump right in. All right, now in our new projects, first things first. On the upper right-hand side, I will click here on our snapping features, and I usually like to work with all these snapping features turned on. Currently, I'm using a millimeter unit setting with a 1 millimeter grid. And then I also gave my project a name. So the first thing is we want to create our basic sketch. So let's go ahead and click sketch and then select one of the side planes. Now the first thing I want to do is create a vertical line that keeps us centered. So I'll start here in the center point and then draw upwards in the x-axis. And then I will select or highlight the first point of that line and then go and click lock. And that basically creates a center point and center line for us to reference future lines and future sketching elements. So now we can go ahead and continue creating our sketch. I'll draw to the right and then up, and then we'll draw a angled line here and again up and over to the vertical line. As you can see, this one, it's not horizontal yet, so we need to add some constraints. So let's highlight this one and click on the horizontal vertical constraint. So that one is now aligned. And we should do this with the remaining ones as well. So let's go and click horizontal vertical and this one as well, just to make sure. Now that we have done that, we need to add some dimensions. So first, we want to add the overall height as a dimension. So let's go ahead and give that a 60 millimeter value, and then this lower one could be 25, and also the top one, we want to give that one a, let's go with 30, it's fine, and then two more here, this one we'll go with 35, and then here on the bottom let's go with 15. And as you can see, this angled line basically will respond to all the other dimensions. So if I want to go higher with this one, the line will be steeper. Or if I want to just decrease this dimension, this angle will be wider. So let's go back, select this one, and keep it at 30. So this is our initial sketch, and we can exit the sketch now. And we want to now revolve this volume. So what we can do is highlight the area and also at the same time highlight this vertical line from the sketch. And Sketcher already knows and gives us some options. So we can either now rotate the sketch around the axis that we selected, or what we want to do is revolve. So click revolve and then keep it at 360 and click OK by selecting this white space here. So this is our initial volume. And as you can see now, the sketch has disappeared. If we go into the items, the sketch that we made has been hidden. But if we want to change any of the dimensions, what we can do is we can go to the right side and then click on the sketch here in the history. And that allows us to immediately change either one of those dimensions. So now the next thing we want to do is with this initial volume, we want to add some rounded corners. So let's select those two edges and then draw outwards to round those corners, and I'll keep it at 10 millimeters. So we now want to make the flutes. So the flutes need to align with the outer surfacing of the volume. And what we want to do is we want to have a contour line that follows the outside surfaces. And how I'm going to do this is we can create a cut through our volume in order to create these contour. So let me show you what I mean. Let's go to tools, and then we will find a split body tool. We can split this body with one of our side planes. And you can already quite see what this will do. So let's go and hit done. So now we have split our body into two. You can also see this in the items menu. We now have two bodies. So we can hide the first one and then go into this newly created plane and create a sketch. So now what we can do is project this contour that we want. So these five lines here on the side, we can project them onto this plane. And that will help us create our flute. So exit the sketch, that's all what we need. And then unhide the first body again. Select both of these halves, and then we'll actually union them again. So we just split them in order to create our contour line. So we now have one body again, but we also have a new sketch. So this one follows our surface on the outside. That's what we want. So for the flutes, let's create a circle, and I will go with this plane here on top. Let's go with a sketch and a circle, and then select this point, basically the end of our contour, and then create a circle. I'll just dimension this one with a 3 millimeter diameter. That's all we need. Exit sketch. And now let's create our flute, our first flute. So I'll select these areas and also double click on our sketch. And that will select the whole line up until the end. And then go and select the sweep function. And I will sweep our circle all the way down to create our first flute. So now we have a new body. So in the items, you will see body 02 has been added. And what we want to do is double click our new body or select them in the items menu and then go to pattern, circular. So if it's on linear, go to circular. And then we'll move our center point. So click and move it to the middle, and it will always snap because we have our snapping features on. Now let's go with a total angle of 360. So I will just draw the circle and then make sure it's either minus or plus 360 degrees. And we'll go with, let's see what 100 does for us. It might be a little bit too much, so let's go with 80. And they need to intersect at least a little bit. So I think 80 is fine. Let's go done. What we have now is a long list of items. So in our circular pattern, we have a lot of different bodies. So they're all copies of our first flute. And what I want to do is now select all of them. And the easiest way is to go into the white space and just click and hold our pencil. That opens up the area selection. And if we go from the left to the right, it will include everything that is inside this blue rectangle. If we are going from the right to the left side, you would just need to touch the rectangle in order to select them. So either way is fine. We'll just need to select all of them. And then we'll choose the union function. And that will create a singular body again. The next thing is now we want to make this a little bit more smooth, because right now we have the outside radii, but the inside corners are still hard edges. So let's see how we can fillet all of these edges. Of them, there are 80, since we revolved it 80 times. Instead of selecting them each individually, we will again use the area selection tool. But right now, we need to do one more thing. If we do that, we also select the faces, and we don't want the faces, we want our lines. Because if you click now to our chamfer fillet tool, you will see that it also selected the top edge and the bottom edge here, which is not what we want. So what we do is we first go into tools and then go to the chamfer fillet tool and then select it again. So from the right to the left, select all these upper edges, and you will see that now only the vertical edges have been selected. And the good thing is, since this is continuous, you will see that as soon as we go ahead and give this a 1.5 millimeter radius, the whole edge from top to bottom has been filleted. And that looks fine, so I'll click done. Next, I want this glassware to also get a rounded bottom edge. So for this, I just need to select one of these smaller edges and then go and give that a 5 millimeter radius, and that's okay. And of course, a glassware needs to be hollow. So let's select the top surface, and then we'll need to select shell. I'll go with a 2 millimeter shell. That looks good, so select okay. And this will create our hollow glass. The one thing that we now need to add again is the second rounded edge. So we now again have our flutes, but the vertical lines, they're still sharp edges. So we'll just do the same thing. Go into Tools, select Chamfer Fillet, and then go from the side, from the right to the left with our area selection. And now we'll see that it has selected all these vertical lines, but since the outer lines or outer edges have already been filleted, it will understand that we need to fillet inside edges. Let's give this one a 2 or 3 millimeter radius. And you saw that Shaper just ignored the outside because these edges have already been filleted and the inside edges are now smoothly filleted. So let's go and hit done. And the last step for this glass to be finished is we want to select these two edges and give that one a 0.5 radius and click anywhere to confirm. So now this is our finished glassware product, which we can give a material now. So let's go from modeling to visualization, and then I'll go with a polycarbonate transparent material. I feel like this one gives me the most flexibility. So let's just drag that onto our glass model, and then I'll go up to our materials, and then we can just select a nice bright desaturated blue. And I always like to use the gradient mood environment, which has a little bit more reflections. So that's nice, but I want to try and play with this shape. And maybe I want to create a glassware set with a lot of different items and pieces. So let's try and do that. Let's go back to the modeling workflow, and I want to make a snapshot of our current project. So what I do is I go to export, go to format, and I'll choose a step file, which basically just flattens all the history and creates a file that we can then use later on. So let's go glassware version 1, and we'll save that to files. And now we can go and import our step file that we just created. So it has been imported, but you won't see it because it's basically the same one on top of each other. So we need to go to the items, and you'll see that we have our glassware step file in a new folder. And we can now select this folder and move it to the side and click anywhere to confirm. So now what that allows us to do is we can still access all our history from the original file. And we can go back into the first sketch that we did, go normal to sketch, and now play around with these dimensions. So for example, I want to make a higher glass. Let's go and change the overall height to 100. We need to wait for it to process. And then let's change these distances as well. And that does look good for me. So let's go out of the history and out of the sketch. And now you have two completely different glassware products. So we can do now the same thing and export this new model as well. For that, if you have imported something else, let's do the following. Hide the step file, and then if we go to export, make sure that include hidden items is turned off. So you will only export the visible parts. And save to files and close that one. So now if we go to import and use our second file, we now have this one here as well. We can move that one over to the side as well. And we still have our first one, which we can unhide. So what we can do now is we can reverse these settings. So let's go with 20 and then change the overall height. And that immediately creates a completely different product. So now we have our finished glassware family, and you are still able to play around with the dimensions and see what other shapes you can come up with. So I hope you found this tutorial useful, and you are now able to play around with different variations and versions of your design in Shaper 3D. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.